should sing and dance forever and a day.
I think variety really came to an end when the theatres started to close big time and there was nowhere else to work.
The club scene died, and I don't think any of us saw it coming. One club would close and the other one would close, and next minute you're left without any work.
There was a new wave of comedy, a new wave of entertainment beginning in the late 70s that made Opportunity Knock seem to be old-fashioned. The presentation of Opportunity Knock never really changed from the time that it started. And I always felt, and this is just a feeling, that Huey was very, very reluctant to change that format, and I think that perhaps, with hindsight, was a mistake.
Those were the days.
Opportunity Knock was cancelled in 1978.
Well, friends, that's it. I thank the artists, and you, the viewers, for your support and your votes. For myself, well, it's been a pleasure. May I say there's no truth in that rumor that I'm retiring. Bless you all.
I think Huey was very sad at the end of Opportunity Knock, and I was there on the last recording at Teddington, and he walked off the floor, and there was a party afterwards, and he just walked off the floor and walked straight out of the studio, and we never saw him. He'd done such great things for television, and for just to walk out that studio at the end of the programme, say goodnight to everyone and go, I thought it was quite sad.
When Opportunity Knock finished for Huey, I think it finished Huey, really. He never really got back in. I think he wanted to, but I think he'd had his day by then.
Huey, do you think there's any danger that now that the show is over, you may be forgotten?
I couldn't care less whether I'm forgotten or not. I mean, that doesn't matter. Now go and ask something else nasty.
Well, what are you going to be doing now?
That's none of your business.
It was three or four years before, I think, Green realised that that was it. And then he wasn't a happy chappy at all.
Do you not have an urge to get out there in front of the cameras again? You must do.
Well, I think anybody who has performed enjoys performing, and I think I would enjoy doing something again. I mean, I think there is time, but the time is around for a show like Opportunity Knocks to come back.
Yeah.
In 1987, Huey's wish was granted. Opportunity Knocks was back, this time on the BBC. They even revived the Clapometer. But it was Bob Monkhouse, not Huey Green, who was to be the show's host.
If opportunity comes your way, don't knock it.
They bought the format from Huey and called it Bob Says Opportunity Knocks, and that was another very bitter blow for Huey. He wanted it to be Huey Says Opportunity Knocks. Didn't happen.
Since his death in 1997, Huey Green has been remembered as much for the scandals in his private life as for his role as the man who brought the talent show to British television.
Since his funeral, it appears to me that he's been written out. And that's a terrible shame because he was a pioneer.
We've learned so much from him. I mean, the bones of a talent show are still what he did.
He was the godfather of talent shows. He was the recognisable face that everybody turned to host the variety show on television.
Huey's legacy is a whole host of household names who have had terrific careers in show business. And the fact that even to this day, all these years after his death, we're still talking about him.
That is show business.
Coming next, we look at how the talent show has created some unlikely stars.
I'm John. And I'm Edward. And here we are, Jedward!
Yes, we're talking about you. But what are the likes of Jedward and Chico actually doing there at all?
Sometimes I think the problem lies when you go, but is this a talent show?
What the bloody hell was that?
For over 50 years, the British public have had the power to create stars. But it's not always the likes of Leona Lewis and JLS who've pulled in the viewers' votes. Seems we've always had a, well, soft spot for the eccentrics out there too.
There's a letter full of sadness and it's black around the border.
Can't be good for you. Even in the early days, unconventional performers like Musselman Tony Holland and poet Pam Ayres were extremely popular.
Oh, fling another sausage in the pan.
And went on to enjoy thriving showbiz careers.
Thank you.
And at the start of the new era of the talent show, one audition proved that the most original of acts could still wow the viewers and the judges.
Hang on a minute, my glasses are steamed up.
The Cheeky Girls to me was a great moment where literally it was great television because the public at home laughed as much as I did.
And you're definitely girls, yeah?
Yes, we are.
Only Louis would ask that question.
I'm just wondering, you know, what's the review now?
The Cheeky Girls brought the fun into the studio that day and we had a great time. So we thought if we're having a great time, the viewer at home is going to have a good time.
Come and smile, don't be shy, talk to my mom. This is life.
It was just hilarious.
We are the Cheeky Girls, we are the Cheeky Girls.
I knew they were fun for the show, but for me, they were here today, they'll be next week's fish and chips. They were not going any further.
You are the Cheeky Boys.
Romanian twins Monica and Gabriella Iremia had clearly struck a chord with the public. Their debut single sold more than a million copies.
The Cheeky Girls are still here, and what are we, 10-odd years later, and they were the kind of ultimate instant celebrity, no-talent show winner.
The Cheeky Girls had shown that there was still a market for the talent show novelty act, and many more would follow.
Cheeky, cheeky.
Since The X Factor began in 2004, the more eccentric performers have played an increasingly important role, often making it through to the latter stages of the competition, providing both amusement and controversy in equal measure. Former goat herder, Chico Slimani auditioned for the show's second series.
One day I woke up, I looked at myself in the mirror and I went, what is the chances of a 34-year-old ex stripping goat herder ever walking into Sony and getting a record deal? And the answer was zilch. And then the X Factor happened and that was it.
To be my girl, you don't have to be cool to rule my world. Ain't no particular song.
Chico is again one of those great characters that turns up that as a producer you would just go, oh my God, thank you God, what have I done so right to deserve this?
Extra time and yeah.
Oh my God, Chico, that was just awful.
It wasn't.
Yeah, the sparkle in the eye, the personality, not a great singer, but had everything else going for him. And we kind of liked him.
You remind me of Julio.
Julio who?
You're winding me up.
No.
More than a few eyebrows were raised when Chico was put through to the next round.
I'm going to agree with Sharon.
Oh.
And you are through. To
you
the
will
next
not
round.
Be disappointed.
I know. No offence, Chico, but you're pathetic.
Although Chico was clearly not the best singer in the competition, his larger than life personality did make for entertaining viewing, especially his performance at Sharon Osbourne's LA Mansion.
He got to that bit, she makes you take your clothes off, go dancing in the rain. I was like, yeah, baby, Chico has arrived. Check this out.
Electric.
Ozzy come up to me and goes, oh, I thought that was brilliant, but you could have electrocuted yourself in my pole.
I've been doing this 35 years, 36 years. I wouldn't jump in water with a live mic, no way.
Chico had definitely got the nation talking, but for some, his presence in the series was undermining what was supposed to be a talent competition.
I remember one day opening the newspaper and it was a double page spread. Is this man the biggest waste of space on TV? And it just hit me and I thought, my God, what am I trying to do? I'm trying to entertain, I'm trying to provide for my family and change my life. Why is it like I must murdered someone, you know? I might have murdered a song or two, but hey, you know.
Big personalities like Chico undoubtedly bring great entertainment to The X Factor.
It's Chico time.
But they also divide opinion.
I don't know